you walk up to a tree like this, what are you thinking about? What do you look at?
Well, the first thing that I always look at is the general shape of the tree. There's a certain specific type that we're aiming for, so we'll deal with that a little bit later. But I guess the first thing we can look at is we can assess the tree to see if we can see any dead or damaged or diseased limbs. So we can take a look at this tree. This is a very healthy tree, so I'm not so sure we're going to find any problems on this one. But we can look.
What about this right here? What do you think about that?
Well, that is a cut from a previous pruning, and it's healing as it should. You can see there's a little dark in the center, but I think that would be still considered healthy, so we wouldn't need to prune that out. You can see the rest of the limbs have good color to them. We can always test the viability of a limb by scratching the bark a little bit, and a good healthy limb will have a green cambium under that. So this limb is just fine.
All right, great. So this is a pretty healthy tree.
This is, yeah.
But we want to demonstrate what a diseased or damaged limb would look like. So maybe we can walk around and find some.
Okay, let's take a look.
Here's a damaged limb. So we're going to cut this one off. And we're going to have to decide to cut it somewhere below the damage. So.
Yes.
What do you think? Where would you cut that?
Well, I'd love to be able to just cut it right there and leave this nice branch, but unfortunately that leaves quite a bit of damaged material behind. So I think we're going to have to go down to one of these branches and one of these limbs. I think the limb that we will prefer is the outward facing limb because that will give us some continuity from the growth of the tree. So I think we're going to have to make our major cut right here.
Find any diseased branches today, which is good.
It is.
But home gardeners would really want to make sure they watch out for fire blight.
Yes, yes, that is the one disease that we can get in this area that is very detrimental to the health of the tree. So if we find that, we definitely would want to remove that.
All right, all right. And fire blight, so that's something we're going to want to look at the end of a limb, right?
That's correct, yes. Yeah. So if we have a young limb like this that has 1 year growth on it, a normal limb would be nice and straight, maybe with a slight curve. But if this limb had been infected with fire blight, we would see what we call a shepherd's crook growth at the end of that. And that means the end of that limb would have turned into a hook just like that. And of course, there's very little reason for a limb, a normal healthy limb, to form in that direction. So we can pretty much say if we see that shape, it probably is fire blight, and we would want to remove that that part of the branch entirely.
Okay, great. So we just discussed how to remove dead, damaged, and diseased limbs. And please stay tuned for the next section where we're going to talk about the bulk of pruning for a tree. We're going to develop the shape of the tree, we're going to allow light penetration through that tree, and we're going to promote good quality fruit. So make sure you stick around for part 3.